Good afternoon, friends. Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live. And listen, I know that there are a lot of differing opinions about the situation that happened down in Miami. I spoke about this on Patreon just recently, give some insights, reminding you of the things that I shared on Patreon before, how that we'd start seeing interdimensional beings. And that, you know, this is certainly something that's happening. But I'm hearing all kinds of people out there that are trying to express, oh, this is Bluebeam Project. Oh, it's doctored footage, everything you can imagine, all kinds of stuff coming out. This channel right here, UFO Mania, the truth is out there. This lady did an amazing job on being able to show one of these creatures here that was captured on camera. But I'm going to look at this too from a biblical perspective. And before I play that, I want to remind you biblically what it says here. This is in Luke's Gospel, chapter 21. Luke's the only one that refers to the part about men's hearts failing for fear. And he does it just like in the case of the Gospel of Matthew and Mark, etc., where it says there should be signs in the sun and in the moon, the stars, and upon the earth, distress of nation with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. We get that even in Matthew chapter 24. But Luke brings out this part that we don't see in the other Gospels. Men's hearts failing them for fear, and looking after those things which are coming on the earth. Well, actually, the part about where it says, those things which are coming on the earth, is a very interesting Greek word that is used there, and it is an invasion. It is the belief of a fearful invasion of some sort that is happening on the earth. That's the way the Greek is actually translated on there, if you begin to really look at that verbiage use. And so I used to think that if their hearts are going to fail for fear, what's it going to be? Some type of 30 foot Godzilla or something like that. Never really thought about it as aliens before until I didn't see this man's video here, but he's going to share with you the black gentleman that speaks about it, which later that black guy comes out and says, oh, I was never there. By the way, some of the technologies these entities do have is the ability to deal with your brain and what you can and cannot remember. Really strange, a lot like X-Files. Let me play this clip here, though, that Potik Fleco says on his channel here. Play this for you.
Mall in Miami.
If you notice the screaming and the running, these people are not playing around. They're getting out of Dodge. According to the Miami, though, is, you know, a bunch of teenagers were out there with sticks swinging at each other. I don't see anybody with sticks or anything. You can see the police. You can see the people running, but you don't see nobody with sticks.
People were running for their lives, shrieking in agony and cries of terror. Now, Miami PD gave a statement and said that people were running at a pace we've never seen before because there were teenagers fighting at the mall and the mall had to evacuate. Now, people were obviously skeptical because they like, bruh, like the police presence that showed up for teenagers fighting is probably the largest police presence we've ever saw.
Esto es una llamada de todas las unidades de la ciudad de Miami.
In fact, the presence was a city-wide call. In other words, every police car in the city was to converge on this mall area. Nothing normal for even a riot. You know, being a former police officer, I know too much well how that works. This was nothing like that. So you don't bring in the entire city to battle a bunch of kids, even if it's a riot between two gang sides there. You don't need that many. I mean, there's probably 100 police cars here.
Esto es en Bayside ahora.
We ain't see this heavy of a police force when JFK was in that drop top ducking tacos. That's not even all of it. There's more police vehicles coming, and there's like four helicopters surveying the scene.
Right at Bayside.
The police response we're seeing at the outdoor mall is equivalent to the response of a national emergency. That don't scream kids fighting at a park. Now, people who was actually there, they decided to speak out, and they stated that they saw something strange.
So, since nobody's going to talk about it, I figured, you know, fuck it. Like, you know what I'm saying? I was down in Miami for the New Year's, you know what I'm saying? Me and my girl, I got a little timeshare. We was down there on a mini vacay, you know, just to start the New Year's off right. So anyway, we happened to be at that mall. So we had Foot Locker or whatever. Next thing you know, you start hearing all this commotion outside, sound like firecrackers or something. So
I can hear the dishonesty in his Neanderthal's breath. It sounds like cloud chasing, but let's continue.
You know what I'm saying? I grab her close. I'm like, yo, we about to get up out of here. Cause I originally thought that they were shooting. You know what I'm saying? I thought, you know, some type of gunfight had broke out, whatever the case is. Cause you know, we're not familiar with Miami. We're not familiar with the city. So I'm like, damn. I ain't even got my blick, so you know what I'm saying? We about to swerve. Next thing I know, it's like crazy. Like we just see all these people running, like, you know, fat chicks, you know, old ladies, like I'm talking about moving. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, old people even move. I'm talking about moving. So you know my girl, she like, what's going on? I'm like, fuck all that, we out. Like, I'm not gonna ask no questions. We just gonna follow the crowd.
As you should. I feel like one group of people, like, don't ask any questions, right? If there's a crowd running this way, frantic and screaming, I'm running that way too, bro. I'm not going the opposite direction. And I feel like if you are part of that group, you understand what I'm talking about.
Next thing you know, real, like, gunshots start going off. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, we trying to follow the crowd, get out of there. I look back, no cap, yo. No cap. I look back. It looked like a big ass shadow, but it was solid at the same time. Like a few shadows, but they were solid at the same time. And it almost looked like they was coming our direction, like they was chasing us, but they was disappearing and reappearing closer. So I'm like, yo, what? So we start really moving. Next thing you know, we start hearing more gunshots. Like these dudes start firing at this shit. Get outside, mad police, all that. You know what I'm saying? The police is like trying to get all the people that ran out the mall. They like trying to like detain these people, whatever. But you know, me and my girl, we ended up just, you know, sliding past all.
By the way, there was a sheriff that his son called him on his cell phone. I don't think the sheriff, or guy running for sheriff, I should say, in Miami. And he told his son he could not speak about the incident of what actually happened there. And his son was saying, for real, Dad? And he said, no, I cannot speak. I cannot make any comments about what happened there. Now, this video here was the first one to surface.
As well.
He's going to show you. Now, they're trying to show that shadow figure there. And, of course, a lot of people are saying they came out later. They're kind of trying to claim that that's fake. Until we get UFO Mania that puts out their video on this, and they did a very good job. They turned some of the film here to black and white. They also showed in color, but watch what you actually get with this one.
I put it in black and white and then really slowed it down as well as turned down some of the brightness. Watch right here. You can see something really tall and kind of translucent. Now here I'm going to back it up so you can slowly see it. You see how tall that is? And it's walking in front. Right there. You see it. And then it kind of disappears into the darkness. Now,
compared
here's
to the police
video.
Car, where it says about 10 foot.
With color, you'll see it. Right there. See it? By the palm tree. And now it's going to walk in front of that building. And see how it's kind of translucent and really tall? And then it disappears.
So anyway, the thing is, when people say that these are, whether just hologram or not holograms, but blue beam, things like that, we have to remember the scripture does say that men's hearts will fail them for fear, for looking after those things which are coming on the earth. Those things, if you look at that word right there, for those things which are coming on, there you go right there, shows you in Greek an impending attack, a supervene that is arrive, occur, or impend, or an attack. And what's odd is that there's been this talk of entities, aliens, whatever you want to call them, that are going to come to this earth and going to wage a war against humanity. Is this what Luke was speaking about in the Bible of Luke chapter 21, verse 26? I don't know. I don't know. Could be worse. But that there didn't cause anybody's heart to fail for fear. But like the guy said, fat chicks and old women, they were getting up out of there. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Have a good day.